I was a lot more, I suppose, aggressive, and I was into fighting when I was younger. But after learning Wing Chun, so I knew there is a lot more to just being aggressive in fight for fighting. There's a lot more to it. So I've learned how to basically remain calm, not to have emotional aspect, but concentrate on what the task I'm doing. What we've been told was Wing Chun was originated in the Shaolin Temple in the old days. It was actually once called the Guardian Fist of Shaolin. It was only available to the hierarchy, the priests in Shaolin, to maintain order in Shaolin Temple. So in the modern days, we can describe Wing Chun is a very, very effective street fighting self-defense system. It's not a sports system. We don't use the emotional aspect, but just concentration. Anything emotional like anger, aggression, fear, they're not good for Wing Chun. So we can use these things. All we focus on is how to concentrate. In our lineage, we basically kept the traditional Wing Chun as it is. We focus a lot of the defensive side. Also, we focus a lot of small details, because the small details are the important part in Wing Chun. We haven't actually got a lot of techniques in Wing Chun. We've only got 8 hands in Wing Chun. And if you've only got techniques without these details, nothing will work, and your technique will just be an empty shell. We don't use brute force against brute force, so we don't use energy, power against energy. I was introduced into Wing Chun by just pure chance and luck. I was only about 14 in 1990. Master Zheng Chengjiu, he taught me everything with no reservation. I didn't ask for anything in return. All I did was basically offer him a cup of tea in the induction ceremony. I never pay him a penny to learn martial arts in the first place. Our relationships are more than just like a modern day students and teacher. The Chinese term sifu is actually means father also, a teacher and a father. So he is almost like a father to me. His teaching is focused mainly on combat and the actual applications. He basically took the skill set of not using force, power against power, not needing power at all, to the highest level. He uses his opponent's energy, and he manipulated this energy and used it against them. So I've never seen anyone achieve such high level before. Both my master Zheng Chengjiu and my sisuk Ng Gui Bo, they are the senior students of Grandmaster Guy Lai. Grandmaster Guy Lai is the action choreographer of the very, very famous Wing Chun film Prodigal Son and Warrior 2 in the 70s and 80s. My priorities now is not just to fight, but also to investigate and study how to attain a higher level in Wing Chun. It brings value to everyday's life, so that people can forget about all this stress and frustration in life, all this emotional aspect, and remain calm and find peace in their life and focus on whatever they're doing. Wing Chun is no limit, no boundary, and no self. I was told by my sifu, my master, if I want to achieve a higher level, I cannot just train. I have to start teaching at this stage. I have the responsibility to spread Wing Chun in the modern society. Anyone can learn Wing Chun. It doesn't matter if you're old, if you're young, if you're big, you're small, you're female or male. It doesn't really matter what body type. Some people might learn faster, some people might learn slower. But as long as you have invested enough time in it, then everyone, I think, can learn Wing Chun.